Subscribe to our channel by clicking the subscribe button. Click the bell button and enjoy the latest uploads from our channel.
अभी आपको लिए चलते हैं कराची, जहां वजीर आजम शाहिद खाकान अब्बासी मीडिया से गुफ्तगु कर रहे
हैं। Before us, five separate attempts had been made to bring energy into Pakistan and all failed. Three governments tried five times to do it and all failed. And we looked at the model and it was very simple, very clear to us why they had failed. Because they have all looked for integrated solutions. One person built a terminal and procured energy and delivered gas to you. It is very obvious that around the world, people who do terminals don't have access to energy. And people who are energy producers do not build terminals. So it was very clear to us what to do. And without investing a single penny in the government, we leveraged our demand. We went to the market. We said, we are willing to pay for you to put up a terminal. And we guarantee you so much throughput, very simple model, and please bid on the terminal to regas LNG that we procure separately. Two companies bid. I'm grateful to the chairman, Mr. Hussain Daud, who initially was very skeptical and did not want to bid, despite the fact that they had done a lot of work, because they were wary of the intentions of the government. But eventually he did bid. Two parties bid. One party was knocked out in the technical stage. The numbers, our own consultant, who were one of the best in the world, had told us that you probably get a price around $1.20. And this has been historically, when the past bid had been done, the component for regasification was $1.2. They said if you get a price below $1, that would be a very great price. The bid was opened, the price came out to 66 cents. With a higher tariff in the first year, which is the way the transaction was structured, it was totally compliant, it was totally transparent. A lot of people questioned it. We answered their questions on live TV, and we had a challenge out there to any so-called expert to come and debate the issue with us. I wrote a letter to all the parliamentary heads in the parliament that hey, this is what we are doing, and if they have any suggestions, if they have any other solutions, to please let us know. We also put out the contracts very transparently, and the price was achieved, and within 11 months of the contract being signed, the terminal was functioning. We had been told, and there was we had an expert who was originally Indian national. He had done both of India's first two LNG terminals, and he said you're looking at 5 to 7 years before you see gas from your LNG terminal. So that's how long it takes. And alhamdulillah, within 20 months of this government coming into power, and within 11 months of the contract being signed, and 14 months of the process being started, the first LNG was flowing in the system. But there was a lot of innovation done. I think this is a real example of cooperation between the government and the private sector. It's quite a challenge when you start doing these things, because they had not been done before. And one of the challenges was that do we procure energy? Because the terminal is not complete and the energy ship shows up, we have a very serious problem. So we looked for an innovative solution, and what we did was very risky. And I'm thankful to Pharma Fertilizer for helping us do it, where we noted the FSRU which is coming in with a cargo that was owned by Pharma Fertilizer. So we did not have to wait for our first shipment to arrive. So the terminal started on time, started regassing, and I'm especially grateful to Ala Jan, the chairman of PGWA, who initially did not believe in the project, but once he started believing, then he delivered very, very quickly. So I'm very grateful to him for great support in making this happen. Because this was something new, there were a lot of questions about it, risk analysis, all sorts of issues, but Port Qasim came through and the terminal started operating on time. A lot of people contributed to this, Mr. Hussain Daoud's team, Mr. Ali Ansari and Sheikh Imran at that time, their contribution needs to be recognized. The Secretary of Petroleum at that time, Mr. Abid Saeed, his contribution needs to be recognized. And there was a lot of flux in that period. If you remember, the dharna was taking place, and I still remember that we used to work late, and one day the demonstrators took over the road leading to the offices. So the Secretary and myself, we waited at night and we walked through the parking lot and we climbed over the wall and through the jungle and we walked home. Because there was no other way to get home. We did not want to be searched by the demonstrators who were searching cars going out of the office complex. So anyway, those things are behind us. What the terminal is doing today, which no other terminal in the world has done, we contracted another 200 through a bid process. The rate is down to 47.99, I think, of which Ala Jan charges 5 cents as a royalty. And which again, and he charges a lot of money for the ships coming in also, but I'm not mentioning it here. But the 100th ship has already come here. I think the 102nd ship is here. And I looked at the net and no other terminal has reached the 100th ship in such a short span of time. So it's a real achievement for Pakistan. And today, this terminal is the largest single source of gas for Pakistan. No field, Surui today produces 450 MMCFD. This terminal gives us 600 MMCFD nominally, which if you factor in the heat rate, is about, it delivers about 660 MMCFD of pipeline quality gas into the system every day. The CNG sector had shut down. Today it has been revived. So it's a market-based system. People procure their LNG-based gas and they sell it to the consumer in competition with petrol. Our fertilizer, we were importing 1 million tons of fertilizer. Today, this year, we'll inshallah be exporting 600,000 tons of fertilizer. All power plants today are functioning, their gas is available. Industry is down to 2 days of gas a week. They have gas available on a full-time basis. All IPPs, all captive plants, everybody has gas available to them on a full-time basis. And we managed to put up 3 large combined cycle gas turbine power plants, which collectively use about 550 MMCFD of gas. And if somebody talks about the cost of LNG, let me tell you, those plants will produce 30 billion kilowatt hours per year. Our total furnace oil based generation is also 30 billion kilowatt hours per year. If we shut down the furnace oil plants, we pay the capacity charge, we still save $1.5 billion a year. And the cost of the energy today for those plants is $1.4 billion a year. So you actually, at today's low oil prices, actually have free fuel for those 3 plants if you do pure replacement of the furnace oil. Because it's very simple, the gas-based plants have efficiency of over 60%. The furnace oil generation in Pakistan collectively is below 35%. So the efficiency savings pays for the fuel itself. So there is a huge shift and this will continue. We are, more terminals will come in. Our second terminal inshallah will be online toward the early November. And there are at least 3 other terminals being put up in the private sector. I think that is our real success. That there is confidence in the private sector today who want to put up their own terminal, who want to bring their own LNG, who want to deliver gas from that LNG to the customer and get paid for it directly without the government being involved. All the government has to do is to provide third-party access and the pipeline capacity, which will be paid for by the gas consumers, and that's all we need to do. And Pakistan, the energy issues will be, inshallah, be solved for a long time to come, all through the private sector, without the government being involved in any way. So that's the real success that this government has achieved. So I look forward to agro-investing more in the sector. I look forward to the other investors who are the world's leading players. We have one project which has not achieved FID yet, but we hope it will achieve FID in a few weeks, which is owned by Engro and Total and Qatar Petroleum and Mitsubishi and Hope. So world-class players are coming and looking at Pakistan, looking at this sector, and they will inshallah deliver gas to solve our energy problems. So again, let me thank all of you here for being here today. This is really Pakistan-led, Pakistan-owned, and Pakistan-driven solution that you see here. It's not a very visible solution, but the energy crisis that this government has fixed, this is a large part of that solution. And what has been done here really is no less than a miracle. Nobody believed it. Everybody thought it will take years before Pakistan sees energy terminal and energy-based gas, and it was done in a period of less than 14 months from start to the first gas. So again, let me thank Mr. Hussain Dawood and his team and all of you here, I wish you more success. Alhamdulillah, this terminal has operated successfully without any serious issues for over 30 months now, delivering gas to Pakistan's energy, for Pakistan's energy needs, and I'm sure there will be a success in the future. This is a success story quoted by the energy community all over the world. Bangladesh started years before us, and they have yet to see their first LNG-based gas. Alhamdulillah, we've been operating for over 30 months now. So I thank all of you, and I hope that Engro continues to grow and Engro contributes more. I know they're talking about a second terminal, and I wish them success with that terminal also. Thank you very much.
आपको बताते चलें कि कराची में वजीर आजम शाहिद खाकान अब्बासी एलएनजी टर्मिनल इफ्तिताही तकरीब से खिताब कर रहे थे, जिसमें उनका कहना था कि माजी में एलएनजी पाकिस्तान लाने की कोशिशें नाकाम रही। दो पार्टियों की एलएनजी की बोली कराई गई थी, एलएनजी की बोली का अमल मुकम्मल शफाफ रहा। एलएनजी टर्मिनल 330 दिन के रिकॉर्ड मुद्दत में तामीर हुआ। एलएनजी का ठेका शफाफ तरीके से दिया गया। ये थी आज ताजा तरीन।